The crisscross is a funny exercise because most of us have done it before ever setting foot in a Pilates studio. This means we usually come in with a lot of bad habits, and that's what we're going to unlearn in this tutorial today. I'm Hannah Ray from Clarity Pilates, and I'm so excited to take you through this intense ab exercise and show you how to get the most out of it. So first we'll talk about the hands. In Pilates, we stack the hands instead of interlacing the fingertips. We'll come back to this later. And then we're gonna bring the knees into the chest. Extending one leg out to about 45 degrees, you're gonna keep your elbows wide and twist towards the bent knee, and then switch sides. You can see I'm keeping my elbows as wide as possible. And when I twist, I'm looking down over my back elbow while my top elbow lifts to the ceiling. This is allowing my abs to turn on while still being long and giving me that beautiful posture Pilates is known for. Let's break it down. Going back to the hands being stacked instead of interlaced, if you try both, you'll find that when you interlace your hands, you sort of create almost like a sling for your head that you can relax into, and we're trying to engage in this exercise, so hands stacked is much more active. Aside from that, the main bad habit I see people bring to this exercise is elbows to the knees. This is a cue a lot of teachers in and outside the Pilates community use, but we're gonna talk about why it's not effective and what to do instead. Let's take a look at what elbows to knees really is doing for our body. So when I'm twisting my elbows to my knees, if you look at my torso, I'm actually not twisting or engaging my core at all. I'm literally just flapping my elbows back and forth, kind of like a chicken. And it's not really turning on any of my muscles. So what we're gonna do instead is keep the elbows wide, and instead of thinking elbow to knee, we're gonna think elbow to ceiling, and look at my torso and how much more I'm twisting and moving in my core, getting way more muscular engagement, and I'm also keeping a lot of tension out of my neck and shoulders. Now, this is easier said than done. A lot of beginners try this and are like, that is too difficult to start with. So here is a breakdown you can use if you're new. Keep one foot on the floor and lift the other knee to a tabletop. Pushing down through your foot on the floor, I want you to curl up high as you can, and then push through the floor as you twist to get the elbow to the ceiling. So we're just creating a little oppositional force here as we ground the body, and then you can do that on the other side. You're gonna feel this foot down pushing into the floor really is gonna help a lot in helping you create that lift and twist without yanking on your head with your arms. As you twist now, I want you to look with your eyeballs over your back elbow. That's gonna help keep your neck aligned and help you get deeper into your twist. If you're doing this along with me, let's do one more together. Beautiful. And then when you rest, you'll hug both knees into your chest. Really well done. I hope that this tutorial answered some questions for you about this really common exercise and will help you get more out of it. If you still have questions, let me know in the comments below or ask me during one of my live classes, which I've also linked up for you down in the description. I would love to see you there. And of course, if you want to support more free videos and tutorials like this one, please like this video, subscribe to the channel, and leave me a comment down below letting me know what you'd like to see next. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time on the mat.